Good morning, everyone. We are continuing here with the halachas in the Kitzur Shulchan Aruch of Rosh Hashanah. And he writes the following today. Nochayin shelo l'shamish mitosai b'shtei leilis de Rosh Hashanah. It is appropriate and is fitting for a person, a husband and a wife, not to have marital relations on the two nights of Rosh Hashanah. It's Yemei Hadin, it's the days of judgment, and HaKadosh Baruch Hu is watching us to see our actions and our behavior. And we have to have a certain level of seriousness which we approach the days. And therefore, to indulge in the pleasures of marital relations on Rosh Hashanah is something that we should avoid. Afilu keshechal b'Shabbos, even when Rosh Hashanah falls out on Shabbos, where we know there's an extra mitzvah for a husband and wife to have the einig, the pleasure of being together on Shabbos, but on Rosh Hashanah, we avoid that. Ach im hilel tvila, except if it's the night that his wife is supposed to go to the mikvah, then there's a mitzvah for her to do so. And al yivatel anoisa, a person, a husband and a wife, shouldn't lose out on that mitzvah that she has. However, says the kitzur v'yitpol es atzma v'beike mitumasai, in the morning then, after relations at night, the husband should go to the mikveh to spiritually cleanse himself for the davening and the tekiah shofar, the blowing of the shofar the next day. Next halacha. B'Rosh Hashanah k'shomer Avinu Malkeinu chatanu lefanecha. On Rosh Hashanah in our davening we say, Avinu Malkeinu, our father, our king. Chatanu lefanecha, we have sinned before you. We're not allowed to take your fist and hit and strike your chest the way that we do during the week or the way we do on Yom Kippur. Why? Because we're not saying vidui, a confession, confessing our sins on Rosh Hashanah. It's a Yom Tov. And on Yom Tov, on a holiday, there's no confession. We don't do tshuva. None of that. So then, how do we say the words, our father, our king, we have sinned before you? That sounds like a confession. Sounds like we're admitting to our sins. El yichav en ha-perish. Rather, you should think the following when you say these words. Avinu Malkeinu, our father, our king, chatanu lefanecha, we sinned before you. Klema, what does that mean? You should think, aviseinu chatu lefanecha. Our forefathers sinned before you. If you go all the way back in time, you'll see that our forefathers served, they went against you. They denied you by serving Avodah Zarah, idol worship. But we recognize we have no other king besides you. Therefore, our father, our king, our father, who our idolatrous forefathers served, but Malkeinu, you are our only king. Asay imanu leman shemecha, do for us kindness, and kindly for your sake, HaKadosh Baruch Hu. And the last halacha today is b'shas haitzah sefer Torah, nagin lo meshloshes haimidais. The custom on Rosh Hashanah is that when the Sefer Torah is taken out, we recite the Yud Gimel Midos, the 13 attributes of mercy, which we say also during the days of Slichos. V'yesh lahaschil min v'ya'avor v'yomer v'ya'avor Hashem apanav v'yikro Hashem Hashem. And there are those who start from v'ya'avor, but many only start with the name of Hashem Hashem, the actual Yud Gimel Midos itself. Well, b'Shabbos, even though it's not this year, but on Shabbos, yesh mekayim she'enom Yud Gimel Midos, they don't say the 13 attributes of mercy, and that is the prevailing custom, certainly in the Ashkenazi world, on any Yom Tov that falls out on Shabbos, even though that it's customary on a Yom Tov that falls out during the week to say the 13 attributes of mercy, on Shabbos we don't say it. Okay, tomorrow, Be'ezah Hashem, it's going to be Tuesday, and we are going to begin the halachas of Tekiah Shofar, the blowing of the Shofar, which hopefully we'll be able to see enough of it to carry us up until Rosh Hashanah, that we should understand a little bit more what exactly we're listening to and the mitzvah of Shofar that we are engaging in on Rosh Hashanah. We'll look forward to learning tomorrow, and we're wishing everyone today a wonderful day.